Well, I hope everyone can see me okay in this limited light. I'm just about to put the kayak in the water. We're going to paddle upstream about a half mile, and then we're going to wait for daybreak. Hopefully we hear some birds today. We heard one or two yesterday, but hopefully they got a little more and they're more cooperative this morning. I can hardly talk, I'm tired. But anyway, no sense in wasting any more time here. Let's get moving and we'll wait for it to get light.
Time again. Man, that's a long ways off. I tell you, you can't complain about the weather. That's for sure. It's been, the past 2 mornings have been beautiful. Yesterday was mild. I think it was in the low 60s, sunny all day. Today's supposed to be just a touch warmer, about mid 60s, upper 60s, and clear skies all day. I guess you could complain about the goblin activity. Couple yesterday, but a long ways off. I had one, it was fairly close, a couple hundred yards, but he gobbled once and that was it. This morning I've heard 4 gobbles from, I'm guessing, the same bird, but sounds like it's about 2 miles away on private. So I'm just sitting here on the riverbank, listening to both sides, as public on either side. Jordan was hunting on that side yesterday, that power line right there. He saw a couple birds cross it and head up this way. He thinks one may have been a gobbler, but just gonna sit here and listen for it to get good light and then do some running and gunning. It's a huge track behind me, over 1,000 acres. About half that across the river. So I'm just gonna sit here and listen for a little while longer and then we'll start moving. Well, I just got a text from Jordan. He went to a spot this morning. It was bow hunting only. Didn't see or hear much. He's going to try another track of land this morning. He's headed there now. He said if it doesn't do anything, he's going to head back home. So it's just me now. And I'm gonna probably call it quits on this area today if I don't see anything or hear anything promising. I'm gonna head to another track, but I'm staying in Mississippi. I got up to 11 days if I wanna spend it here. I'm actually going to Tennessee, but that's not a guarantee. I may end up spending a lot of time here in Mississippi. Some of the scratching I'm finding this morning doesn't look as old as what I found yesterday. And you see some right here, this looks like it may only be a few days old. And combine that with all the old scratching, it's obviously an area they use often. If you're a local to this area,
without me telling you where I'm at. You know where I'm at. River, airplanes, public land. You guys know where I'm at. All right, we're just coming up on an area that I look for on the map, satellite images, when I'm hunting a new place. I'm never gonna get a break from these airplanes. Just bear with me because these planes are nonstop taking off and flying over. They're making a lot of noise. But what I want to tell you is that when you're looking at a satellite image of a new place you want to go to, especially in the south, southeast, where there's a lot of pine forests or these large tracts of lands that everything looks the same, key in on the transition areas and cover. Just like with deer hunting, they love those transition areas. Other wildlife likes it too because there's cover and food. Turkeys love it. And you got some small pines right over here, some larger, more mature pines, a little mix of mature pines here and some hardwoods. And so it's a good transition line here. I can already see down at the bottom of the hill some fairly fresh turkey scratching, and I can see some older stuff here. So when you're looking at a big tract of public land, and it doesn't have to be in the south, it can be anywhere, look for those transition lines and just concentrate on scouting those areas and looking for birds, and it'll really shrink down the amount of area you have to cover. So we're gonna just walk these transition lines and look for sign and try and strike a bird. Oh my goodness. Got some turkey tracks. Isn't that amazing? First set of turkey tracks I found the entire 2 days or day and a half I've been here. Impressive. We're coming up on a little drainage right here in front of me, and I'm gonna walk this drainage just looking for turkey tracks. I see human boot tracks, but they're dated. They're worn out and it's done rained on them. You can tell they're not crisp. So I'm okay with that, but I'm looking for turkey tracks too, fresh ones. That's mainly what I'm looking for. I'm not looking for hunter's boot tracks. You can see where he came back out. It doesn't mean that was a turkey hunter. It could have been somebody putting trail cameras out. Who knows? Most likely a turkey hunter though. He had the same idea I did about walking the ditch. Smart turkey hunter. That is marked a listening spot, today's date and the time. And then I'll put notes to it if I hear anything or discover anything. I think I'm gonna take this. There's a trail, this trail here behind me goes that way quite a ways, and I can get on the backside in between some creeks and things. And those may act like funnels. It might be a good spot to deer hunt the turkeys. If the sign looks promising, that's probably what I'll do. This is looking like a pretty good spot. This roadbed comes out to some big woods on my right. We got down here, we got a little slough or a little swamp pond of some sort. To my left here, we got, I see some muddy water, something's down there stirring it up, probably a beaver, but a canal here makes a 90. So turkeys traveling through here. Walk this way here. Other wildlife does too. It's probably why it's so worn out. And might catch them going by, so it might be a good spot to set up down here. And there's a transition area. Look at all these little pigs have been rooting it up. I see some pig tracks. And along these pines here would be a good spot, and I see some more mixed woods. Yeah, this will look good. My biggest spot set up. Yeah, you can see this is beaver been coming through here. Crossing over from one side, you can see the trail there, crossing over to that side. High density of beavers back here too. This just looks too good not to have a pile of turkeys in it. Looks like somebody had the same idea that I did to come back in here, but this is not fresh. If I step right here beside it, I'm barely leaving an impression. They were back here when it was much wetter. You can tell it's a little worn out. And it's deeper, so it's not like they were in here yesterday. It's probably been a week at least. So even when you see tracks, it's not the worst thing to see. And it also can mean a clue that it's a local and they know there's turkeys back here and they're hunting them. So maybe I'm on the right track. No pun intended. Gonna ease up through here. These woods are gonna start looking better and better based on what it looks like in the satellite image. I think it's getting that time of morning. It's gonna be 9:30, 10 o'clock here soon. And big time for a good blind set. Just do some blind calling and see if I can round up a bird. I just about had a heart attack. Just slipping through the woods here and I was looking around, possibly wanting to set up. And one more step, maybe two, I would have stepped on this fella right in front of me. Look at those rattles on it. That's a big snake. And look how well he blends in. Let me back out here a little bit. Look how well he blends into the leaves. That's just crazy. That's a big snake though. We'll see you later. Well, we'll never see you again, hopefully. I don't know if I'd hear a gobble if one did sound off of all these airplanes. They're very annoying. What also is annoying is the fact I can't find any turkeys hiding back here other than that old hen track. And all that scratching in that one hen track was closer to the river, and I'm making my way back there now. hopefully I'll run into some fresh sign close to the river. But back here in the interior, I'm only finding rattlesnakes. So we're getting closer to the river, and just as I suspected, we're finding turkey sign. It's old, but it's turkey sign. Sound like a you know, young bird, spring key. But it was real low, faint. I'm just walking in this dirt right next to the woods, looking for turkey tracks. And I suspect I won't find any very fresh ones in here because the ground's kind of hard now, but at least it gives me indication that turkeys are indeed back here and using this area. Plus, I'm using this hill right here to my right as a little bit of cover.
Well, I got another set of turkey tracks here. This was made at a different time when the ground was much wetter. You can see where the hen or whatever it was sinking way down in the mud. And I'm sinking a little bit. I'm gonna get stuck here. Oh, crap. Boot got stuck. In the mud. Now my foot's got mud on it. Don't worry about washing my boot out later. Boot track, footprint. Looks like some other poor soul almost suffered the same fate that I did going up that hill. You know. That's rough. Well, it was nice and cool on my feet though. That is nasty. Could you imagine a 12-pound hen sinking 6 inches? It had to be really soft then. Well, we're getting close to where I need to set up. There's some hardwoods over here. And this little slough right here is pretty much ending right here on this point. Then hardwoods over here mixed with pines. This would be a good little area probably if there's any turkeys around. And there are boot tracks in here. I see two different sets. There's a boot. There's a different size boot. Don't forget about my boots. That's a 300s. I got a couple sets of tracks here on the ground. One looks like a hen, and the other looks like our first gobbler track. And both of them are kind of aged. But I was following the other hen tracks, at least two different hens that I saw, and all of them are kind of coming this way. This seems to be a nice little travel corridor from, you know, good hardwoods to other good hardwoods. There's a lot of sand in here, and you can see right there's a berm, like a little dike or something, and the river's behind me. So I think if I just tuck up in these pines here and be within gun range of that little berm there,
I can blind call and just maybe hopefully a turkey will come through. And if they pop up on that berm there and just look into this little bottom, I'll be within gun range of it. So I'm gonna just walk a little bit in here just to look for some more tracks, and then I'll set up and blind call for a little while. What's happening?
Hey, what's going on, man?
Just sat down, gonna do some blind calling here, trying to find a turkey in this dump.
Yeah, I'm just heading back to the truck from spot number two, getting ready to go to spot number three.
You killed one in Tennessee yet?
No, I missed one up in the morning. I actually missed twice. Killed birds. I think I misjudged the distance. I was covered up in the morning, but that spot, there's been at least two trucks there every morning since Saturday. There's two there today.
Oh, so that sucks.
And I know there's been at least three shots out of there, probably five or six. So I have to guess just about how much people went hunting it. So I'm going to little spots here and there that have been good in the past. What about you? What you got going on as far as...
I'm just trying to find turkey sign. I found some old scratching. I found some old hen tracks today, and I finally found my first gobbler track.
Yeah.
I've heard some gobbling. I heard gobbling this morning and yesterday morning, but they're way off on private. I mean, and they gobble three times and stop. I had one gobble yesterday morning about 200 yards from me on the public. It gobbled once, and I never heard it again, never saw it.
I'd go back to him.
Yeah, that's the problem. I wanted to go back to it, but I need my buddy down here because we kayak in from the north and go downstream. It's about 2 miles downstream. And then you got to float another 4 miles to get to the other boat landing. Had he stuck around where he would have picked me up, I would have floated in from the north and hit that spot again.
Yeah.
Anywho.
I worked two birds yesterday, two different spots, both of them on private. Both of them I couldn't quite pull off the private. The second one was right before sunset, and I had him drumming. I could hear him scratching, and he was just over the rise, like right on the boundary, all the way up over the rise. And he started putting and walking back and forth just out of sight. And he did that for like 15 minutes until he worked his way back on the private. And then I was sitting there waiting for him to fly up to see where he roosted. And I started hearing drumming again right about sunset. And then I saw a bird fly up, and I saw another bird fly up. I saw like six or seven hens fly up with him.
Well,
so
did you go back there?
I guess I pulled them off his hands. I didn't go back there today because they all roosted on the private. There's a pasture out there that they came off of that they probably just pitched down in there and strutted around.
Yeah.
I might go back. If I don't have any luck anywhere else today, I might go back there this evening and see if they come down and roost by that creek.
Well, good luck the rest of your hunting today, and I'm gonna get quiet here and start listening. We'll talk to you soon.
All right.
Yeah.
All right, keep it posted.
All right, later. I will. Holy cow, a turkey gobble. Never would have believed that. might be wild and crazy here. He's drifted over that way. Yeah, he was over there, now he's there. I could probably peek over that berm, lay eyes on, but I could also get busted. Stay patient. I can always come back tomorrow morning if this doesn't work out today. I know he's over. I know there's a gobbler here now. Back further that way. Slide a bit closer to him.
camera into the dirt. Thank you.
Mississippi, Longbeard, down. Public land. Oh, man, that's exciting. Let's get in and take a look at him.
I hope this excitement in me right now stays for a long time, because it was quite the rush, quite the adrenaline rush, quite the tension, quite the nervousness, and quite the surprise, really, that this bird was even in here. I scouted yesterday evening in this place, had the best sign near the river, so I came in here this morning, didn't hear any gobbling. Decided to do a big loop through it and check it out and scout it, and I found a couple of hen tracks, and they were old. And then I found a set of gobbler tracks right over this berm, and they were old, but I figured, you know, what the heck? Let's do some blind calling. I was tired anyway, and probably would have taken a nap had I sat there very long. Just as I sat down, was getting settled in, Jonathan Bohm called me. He has a YouTube channel called Catman Outdoors. Very good channel. I'm going to hunt with him in Tennessee this weekend, as a matter of fact, and that's what he called me about. See how it was going down here in Mississippi and tell me how things were going in Tennessee. And I told him how crappy it had been here, really. The hard work had been putting in and just the lack of sign and things just didn't please me very much. So I got off the phone with him, and as soon as I got off the phone with him, I made a call and this bird sounded off. And we played cat and mouse here for a while. He'd come closer and then he'd drift off. And there's this little berm here, and I should have made my move sooner, but I just kind of was worried that he might bust me. And so I finally got the nerve up to make an advancement, because I had the berm was going to hide me, and I got up there peeking over, and I called to him. He had drifted away again, and so I figured, you know what, he's not responding well to just the yelping. I best pour it on a little bit. So I began a cutting sequence, you know, some excited calling, cutting, and immediately that turned him around, and he come up through here. And he popped out, he strutted a little bit, and then he started pecking some stuff. And I just made a little perk perk and got him to stick his head up. Probably wasn't, I don't know, 25, 30 yards max to that little berm. And you can see it right over my shoulder there with that opening is there. That's where I was at, and he came out and gave me a shot. So super pumped, man. I'm talking about going from just down in the dumps feeling like this nothing's going to happen to hot bird, some of the action that you always want to get a bird gobbling. I don't always want them just running into the call. I like to be able to work for it a little bit. But at the same time, I don't want him to get away either. So I was pleased when he finally came on in and gave me a shot. So we're gonna get this bird back to the kayak. And oh my goodness, I don't know. I'm gonna soak this in for a long time. This is cool. Mississippi Public Land Gobbler.